Hi there. Today on Typical Books, we're going to talk about some new books coming out this month. Now, of course, all of these are typical books. You can see even more over at horror.org. These are the books that are coming out from Horror Writers Association authors. I am curating a larger list for the monthly magazine podcast. So if you're interested in that, check out typicalbooks.com. There's some information there on how to get at that. So without further ado, here are some new books from Horror Writers Association authors. This is one that is out now, and I forgot it in the list last time I did a video like this, and it was Sentinel by Drew Starling. And this comes from Eerie River Publishing, a publishing house I'd never heard of, so that's pretty cool. But the cover I loved, and I kicked myself for forgetting to mention this particular book. Something is lurking in the woods beyond Aaron and Ellen Dwyer's country home, and an evil that has been hiding in plain sight for centuries is about to emerge. When their four-year-old son goes missing in broad daylight, the town of Ben Salem devolves into a cesspool of finger-pointing and chaos. With nowhere left to turn, Aaron and Ellen are forced to venture into the woods to find their son and the truth. So that synopsis actually sounds like something I'd love to read. So I'm, like I said, kicking myself for forgetting to mention this, and I love the cover. A starkly graphic cover here with the Downriver People. This is out from Boom Comics from Adam Smith and Matthew Fox. A young man inherits the family speakeasy after his father's death. When his local booze supplier dries up, he's forced to buy from his estranged mother and her new husband. As he becomes closer to the new family, he's forced to reckon with their ties to a mysterious cult. I've seen a few question and answer things in various writer forums and Facebook groups lately of people really liking this cult idea, and I know there's quite a few readers here that really like cult stories. There's my friend Amy Vosper loves cult stuff, so this is cult graphic novel stuff if you're into that. Out already, you may have already read this, Chopping Spree from Angela Sylvaine. This is from Unnerving Books. We have two Unnerving Books in this list today. Eden Hills, Minnesota is famous for one thing, an 80s-inspired fashion mall. High school junior Penny lands a job at one of its trendy stores and notices her teen co-workers all wear a strange symbol they won't explain. An after-work party turns to terror when she and her friends learn they are trapped with a masked killer. So some cult leanings there. 80s, I mean, I was an 80s kid, so I'm gonna enjoy that. And the cover is pretty starkly graphic, very 80s as well, so they did a good job there. Wearing Shadows by Simon Paul Woodward. This comes from musingMonster Books, and it is out already. None of us can escape the darkness that haunts our souls. We are all wearing shadows. In the titular novella, a troubled actress undergoes the most extreme occult cosmetic surgery, the amputation of her shadow. Among the short stories included, a game of cat and mouse unfolds, and a father's lies lead his son to the scene of historic betrayal, alongside other unsettling stories with a twist. So yeah, I liked the shadow amputation idea very much. Encyclopedia Sharksploitanica. Encyclopedia Sharksploitanica. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. By Susan Snyder, this comes from Madness Heart Press. With her education as a marine biologist and her experience diving with sharks, Susan brings her distinct perspective to 85 of sharksploitation's most notorious, ridiculous, and sometimes pointless contributions to film. In this all-teeth, no-bones collection of reviews, interviews, essays, rants, and even some poetry, Susan dissects the genre as a whole and explores everything she loves and hates about sharksploitation movies. I don't like sharksploitation movies necessarily. That can't be silly horror isn't usually my cup of snails, but I like the idea for this nonfiction book. So if you're looking for a coffee table book for your shark week and sharksploitation fans, I think that this is exactly what they need. Transmuted, this comes out from Eve Harms from Unnerving. This is part of their Rewind or Die. This is Rewind or Die book 30, and it is out soon. When Issa, a trans woman video iGream streamer, loses her money for facial feminization surgery, she turns to a mysterious doctor offering a free experimental treatment that promises her the face and body of her dreams. Dr. Skirm's gruesome methods give her unbelievable results. But Ice's body won't stop changing and she's going from supermodel to super mutant. I like the idea of this. It sounds kind of Cronenbergian, right? And last but not least, I've seen this cover everywhere it seems. Only the Stains Remain by Ross Jeffery. This comes from Cemetery Gates Media. Two brothers' lives are destroyed following the death of their mother when their three abusive uncles move into their family home. Jude suffers to a degree, yet Kyle is the one who takes the brunt of their attention, submitting himself to preserve his younger brother's innocence. After all is said and done, only the stains of the past will remain. And there you have it. Some really cool cover artwork, for sure, and some very cool premises. You got everything from cults, abusive families, body horror, 80s horror. So I think this is a really good crop. If you have read any of these already, definitely let me know in the comments below. Or, of course, if there's something here that you're going to be adding to your shelves, let us all know. Thank you very much for watching, and have an ooky, spooky day.